Our main event now is a triple threat last man standing match. Two men must be down for a 10 count, and the winner will face Austen G next week for the ESW Shockwave Championship.
Hold you backstage!
Love will be on your hands by the end of the night.
Right. 10, that's it!
And that's it. That's all right. Lose. And Austen G doesn't have to do a damn
thing. What's my celebration?
Thing. Well, guess what?
What?
For the next 3 weeks,
okay, I'm off. Okay.
You're gonna face Officer Miguel and PL3 and Cody Rex.
All three of them?
You're gonna be defending that belt for the next 3 weeks.
I'm gonna be right by your side for each and every one of your matches.
Actually, Alex,
uh-huh.
I got a bit of news for you. Severance papers. You're fired.
No, this was...
Whoa! He made this business! He put you where you stand, man!
Alex G has just been let go of ESW Shockwave.
To welcome you to episode 2, season 2 of ESW's Shockwave. I'm so happy all of you were patient enough, and I'm really happy that all of you are sticking with us. I'm only going to bring you top tier entertainment from here on out, just
Russo!
Like I always...
Russo! Russo!
Austen G coming out.
You gotta listen to me, man. You gotta listen to me.
Hey, look. All jokes aside, Russo, my big brother, Alex G, is the man that put you where you stand. You wouldn't own a business if this business didn't exist. And this business does exist, Russo. And that's because of my big brother, Alex G. So I'm begging you, from the bottom of my heart, please bring my brother back to me. Please! Ah!
Austen, I'm tired of hearing the crying, man!
And here comes Jesus the Christ. Maverick Cody Rex!
Every single week it's the same damn thing! Just like season one, you're doing the crying, but except this time your big brother's not here to defend you! And you know, tonight you're facing Officer Miguel, and that's a big obstacle! But I really do hope that you walk out with that world's heavyweight title tonight, because I really want to kick your ass.
Oh, yeah?
Why? I think you know why. Why? Nah!
Woo! Oh, Austen G trying to do a sick attack, but Cody Rex is on top of it with a Maverick DDT.
I like the look of this, right? Come on, Russo!
Give it back to him so we can stop crying.
Come on, Alex!
Take your title. Keep it nice and shiny for me, baby! Because by the time you take out Officer Miguel and PO3, I'll be next in line! And I'll be walking out World Heavyweight Champion!
Austen G has 3 men to worry about, but no one's on his side.
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have Austen G versus Officer Miguel for the ESW Shockwave Championship. Hi, everyone. I am Travis Ortiz, your host commentator for tonight. And We're going to have Jake Jordan versus Bruno Magnifico right now in that ring. So let's head there now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bruno Magnifico and Milo.
Wait here for me and watch me, you know, those folks, okay? Hold it.
This relationship or whatever it is does not seem healthy. Remember, it was last week that Jake Jordan challenged Bruno Magnifico for this match.
Yeah! Jake Jordan! Episode 2!
Hi, Nyla. Hi, Nyla.
Hey! Don't be talking to her!
Come on!
These two men are very fascinated by Nyla. And Bruno Magnifico is not letting this happen at all. Remember, it was last week that Jake Jordan challenged Bruno Magnifico for this match.
Come on, Jake, you can do it. Yeah. I told you. That's it. I'll kick your butt.
Jake Jordan literally kicking the butt. Oh, Bruno Magnifico. Nice shot with a missile drop kick from Bruno. Yeah. Looks like Bruno Magnifico is getting the upper hand in this match. Knee to the gut. Some slaps. Oh, and a center kick to the gut. Jake Jordan trying to get this match back on him. Going to the ropes. With a cross body, but Bruno Magnifico just stops him. Puts him on his shoulders. Another drop kick sending Bruno Magnifico down.
Come on.
A magnificent kick.
No. You can do it, Jake. Get up. Get up. Come on. Come on.
Nyla, just the look of concern on her face.
I can't make a bear like that.
Another leg drop.
You should go back to your fight. Science fair, little boy.
These gentlemen are just friends tonight, and Bruno Magnifico does not like it. Big splash from Bruno Magnifico.
Come on! Come on, Jake! Get up! Get up! Dodge it!
Ooh, yeah. Big dodge. Yeah. Jake Jordan getting out
come
of the
on,
way.
Jake.
What are you doing down there?
Right in the love joys. Nyla seems to have thought that was very funny.
That's what you get for treating Nyla bad.
Seems like Jake Jordan has control of this match now.
Do you know how to count, ref?
What does Jake Jordan have to do to put down the bigger man, Bruno Magnifico?
Equation. I think it's time for an equation bomb.
Yeah, equation bomb. Do it.
Looks like he's going for the equation bomb.
Let's go.
He hits it.
Yeah.
Will he get the pin count, ladies and gentlemen? I think he's taking a little bit too long here.
Two.
We have the right equation. That was the answer.
Nyla, give me the chair. Let's give me the chair, please. Give me the chair.
No.
Give me the chair. I need it right now.
He's already hurt us.
And I want to hurt him more. Give me the chair!
Nyla pleading with Bruno not to use the chair.
Give me the chair.
Bruno Magnifico has a chair in his hand. Oh, and a big chair shot.
And we're not done yet.
It's for you, Nyla.
It's all for you.
adding insult to injury, all the B factor by Bruno Magnifico.
One, two, three, that's it.
One foot for the pin count.
Well, you didn't want to pass me the chair.
Because he was already hurt. He really didn't need to use it.
You do what I said, okay? We're in this together.
But we're not.
Five, says who? Five.
No.
We are.
Did I win the match?
Bruno's one of the most jealous guys I've ever seen.
He took Nyla. We gotta go check on
him. He
took
Nyla?
Let's go.
Man, said, I mean, it sucks that he gets the first chance, but...
Yeah,
no, man. We all know who's gonna win that match. He's just gonna tire him out for next week for me, so
yeah,
I find it as a blessing.
Austen's got this in the bag, but I'll for sure take him out.
No. I got this. What's gonna happen is me and you will face each other.
You think Austen's going to beat me?
Well, honestly, yeah.
What's wrong with both of you? Are you both dumb? Tonight, I'm going to walk out ESW champion. And law and order is going to be restored.
One, two,
Oh, no!
That was a good one.
Oh, fuck!
Woo!
Oh,
I like that guy.
Bruno cheated! He cheated! He hit my friend Jake Jordan over the head with the chair! Why would he do that? You need to give me a match, Joey Russo, for revenge! The revenge of the nerds!
I see your stars.
I saw what they did. I saw what he did. And I saw that Nyla was reluctant to do that, and I know they have a history. I wasn't aware of how deep it was. You need to redeem this man. Next week, it's you and Bruno.
Thank you, Joey Russo. Thank you. You won't regret it.
What just happened?
Appreciate y'all putting him out.
Despite what Cody Rex and PL3 think, Officer Miguel does have a chance tonight at that ESW Championship. And we just found out, next week, Tommy Thomas will be taking on Bruno, and that match is set for next week. But up next, Project Robbery version of Young Lolo is heading to the ring. I'll be up next.
All units, we have a 211 in progress. We have two suspects dressed in all black. Masks.
And there he is, ladies and gentlemen. Project Robbery Young Rolo coming out to the ring right now. While very entertaining, Young Rolo is one of the worst robbers because he tried to rob himself last week. Did not look pretty.
Now you see, regular Simon Rolo didn't work so well. That's fine. But Project Robbery Rolo, now that's something. So I'm gonna try this again. I want the conductor in a match, one-on-one. So come on.
Project Robbery Rolo, call out the conductor. Here comes the conductor.
Preferably that I'm a 9 and you gotta get it where the back of your neck set. Better let me know that you rep that. Plus get you out of a death trap. You need it for living cause I'm the king and I'm giving you the permission to get with a no stress pack. Or no set chlorum, cause the old world orders post-mortem is failure. Inhaling, selling Delta. Watched it swell and swelter till it was no melon shelter. Yes, I'm the one that provided your shell and
instruments are the same, I guess the players are different.
So I built this structure just to help ya. So the communists can come and quell.
Same results!
Call me the king of darkness when I offer you no pain. Why would they label me heartless when your love is my cocaine? And your soul is my Rogaine. I have a thirst to
be organizing my bird seeds.
Could be learning my next concerto piece, but no. Gotta come out here, stomp this goofy looking dumb piece. What is this? What are you wearing? What are you doing with your life? Go back and be a regular person.
Oh, give me the money.
Get the hell off of me.
Come on and fight me like a man!
Shades of last week happening again.
This is pathetic.
Conductor again just manhandling Young Rolo.
Is that what you want to see, Shockwave? You want your heroes to return and be degraded by the greatest of
Rolo hitting him with a little drop kick to the bottom of the leg. Rolo trying to do another drop kick, but no one home. The conductor swings out of the way. Conductor again having the upper hand in this match. Russian leg sweep. elbow drop from the conductor onto Rolo. Young Rolo won half of Project Robbery. With Anthony Kelly, I do think they did have some success. Conductor is applying that Boston Crab. He's arcing the back of Rolo.
Come on!
Yeah, that's it.
Have a tech tap, preferably the number nine, and you gotta get it with the back of your neck set. Gotta let me know
what you Shockwave! Look at your hero now! Look at your hero now!
Conductor doesn't seem to be very happy, throwing Ron Rolo outside the ring.
You get fanfare? What makes you think you deserve fanfare? Draven Cross gets fanfare. Jerome gets fanfare after 10 years of not being here. I disappear for two, and no one gives a damn when I return. All you comeback kids, all you bandwagoners that decided to join ESW the second that we were able to obtain a wrestling ring, all of you are gonna pay by the hands of the villain of all man. Now get this piece of crap out of here, Russo.
Russo, what is this? Last week, you set me up with some beer off against that redneck and I lose my title? No. That was a disgrace and an insult to me. I need another match.
You know what, doctor? I thought if we combined redneck and beer and a man of education, I thought we were gonna come up with some awesome formulaic just explosion. I was wrong. But you know what? You answered my call in the middle of surgery. I mean, I don't know if it was a baby coming in or a heart coming out. You answered that call. I appreciate that.
Yeah, wrestling is what I live and die for. And what you did for me last week, an abomination.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna make it up to you. If you can deliver for ESW's fans and give me something bloody for Shockwave Season 2, do you think you can do something like that?
Oh yeah, it's gonna be extreme tonight.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me. I'm only human, do what I can. I'm just a man, I do what I can. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put your blame on me.
Okay, this match is for the NXT Championship, and there's Jax Amadeus, who won it last week in a beer off against the Doctor. Wait a minute, that's the Doctor coming out. Oh, and he just grabs underneath him and just pulls him out of the ring. The Doctor not happy about what happened last week in this beer off.
Let's see what we can get this trailer trash. Hey, Jax. Special delivery.
Oh, trash can lit to the throat from the Doctor. The Doctor just seriously just kicking off Jax Amadeus. Being a doctor, he knows exactly what to attack on a human being.
Real champions enter first. What's this? What the fuck is this? I'm Jackson Mateus. Look at me. I got no education.
The Doctor seems to be just mocking Jax Amadeus right now. Looks like the ref is making sure that Jax Amadeus can get this match on.
I'm gonna go, ring the bell.
Again, this match is for the Anarchy Championship, and it just seems like the doctor is just going heavily with those shoulders inside the gut of Jax Amadeus.
Oh, it's only getting better.
The doctor grabs a piece of steel here. I wonder what he's going to do with this. Jax into that steel.
Ooh, ain't that pretty?
Oh, flatliner leg drop by the doctor, adding more pressure onto the neck. And it seems like he's grabbing his stethoscope just to choke out Jax on the head. The doctor feels cheated that he lost his belt in a beer off last week.
This is why I'm having a third match. To prove the redneck is nothing. Just a veteran. You know, it belongs in the VA's doctor's office. Ain't nothing for me. 8 years medical school. This! Come on!
Only the doctor has not worked on his cardio, apparently. With a big uppercut from Jax Amadeus. Jax Amadeus trying to get back into this match. Trying to get control again. Another big uppercut, this time to the gut.
This one's for you, Jay.
Oh, twist of fate. He calls that Jay's revenge.
One, two, two.
Just gets a two count. Jax Amadeus grabbed something. I don't know what he looked, but it looks like a light tube, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, he just busted the back of the doctor with that light tube.
You want to be a doctor? Let me teach you some medical realm.
Looks like Jax Amadeus is taking the match back inside the ring. Another cheap move done by the doctor, just taking the legs out from underneath Jax Amadeus, and he's just pounding him. Jax Amadeus is trying to get the arm. He's trying to go for an arm bar here, looks like. The redneck doing a little bit of mat wrestling here. Looks like the doctor just turned it into a clover leaf of some sort. And Jax still gets out of it. Both men are on the ground. What's a big clothesline from Jax Amadeus to the doctor?
What's going on?
Looks like the doctor is getting frustrated here.
After this guy.
And again, with a nice duck from the doctor. Oh! And Jax hits the red neck breaker.
One, two, two.
Uh.
Both men stumbling to get up here.
Get up.
Whoa, whoa. The strength of the right neck. Pick up the doctor.
Not up or shut up.
Samoan drop or redneck drop. Jack's going outside the ring. I wonder what he's going to try to look for here. Since this match is for the Anarchy title, so that means there are no rules. Weapons can't be used in this match. Seems to be throwing in a trash can. Wonder what Jax is going to do with this trash can now that the doctor has just been laid out here. And Jack stuffs the trash can onto the doctor.
Soldier kick!
Oh, and he gets him the Second Amendment kick.
Caliber 6!
And he hits a caliber 6. Is this the end of the match? Is this the end of the match? And a two count. The doctor kicks out at two.
No, man, that was three. Come on. No, what did you
do? Jax is convinced that it was a three count.
No, shit.
Looks like the doctor is grabbing a chair. And there comes Jackson. He gets hit with a chair to the gut. The doctor with a very vengeful laugh there. Looks to be he grabbed a piece of that light tube.
Hey, Russo! You wanted blood?
Looks like he's just carving the name of the doctor inside his forehead. I'll be surprised if Jackson be able to finish this match now.
This is what you get, Russo, when you ask for blood.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, he did give us blood from Jax Amadeus in this match. Jax Amadeus is trying to get in the ring, but the doctor is going to stop it by kicking him.
Let's go.
And three punches to the gut from the doctor. He's picking up Jax Amadeus for a sidewalk slam.
One, two.
I can't believe he kicked out.
No! Is that fucking...
Flatliner off the bottom rope!
One,
going for the pin count!
Three, that's it!
And that's it, ladies and gentlemen, the three count! We have a new Anarchy champion, the Doctor!
This show never left my hands!
Russo, that's what you get! Next time you challenge me, expect...
I'm pretty sure he's putting people on notice that he is nothing to be messed with in an Anarchy Championship match.
Somebody say a doctor?
Wait a minute, he's coming back out! What is the doctor gonna do now? The match is over already, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know what he's gonna about to do. He's just dragging the corpse of Jax Amadeus like a rag doll. Where is the doctor taking the redneck? Just dragging him out of the ring. Forcing him to the back, ladies and gentlemen. I have no idea what's going on or what's gonna happen.
What's up, everyone? My name is Queen Liz, and my next guest is Nyla.
Hi.
Hi, Nyla. So I understand things are really rocky. How are you
feeling? Hey, Queen Liz. It's Bruno Magnifico here. So, I can answer the questions to you if you have any questions for Nyla. I can speak for her. And today, I just kicked some nurse ass, and next week is the next one. You better be ready, pal. You shouldn't be talking to her. None of y'all. Not even you. Let's go, Nyla.
Well, next week, we have Tommy Thomas going up against Bruno Magnifico, and that match is set for next week. But coming up next, your Shockwave Championship, Austen G, the champion, versus Officer Miguel.
I'm here to restore law and order by winning the ESW Championship tonight!
Remember, Cody Rex and PL3 do not think he can do this. Let's see if the young man has what it
I'm
takes.
I'm the law, so respect me!
Here comes Austen G. It's been a long time since we've seen Austen G without his brother Alex G.
Aren't you a loser? Aren't you the same loser that lost last week? When something accidentally happened, you see? It doesn't matter if it's you. It doesn't matter if it's the legend. And it sure as hell doesn't matter if it's that punk kid, the Maverick, Cody Rex. I'm holding the gold. But you're not.
You hear that, ladies and gentlemen? Austen G having so much confidence. So I just wonder how Austen G is going to get this done tonight without his brother by his side. Austen G, a little bit hesitant to give up that title. Again, this is for the Shockwave Championship. If Officer Miguel wins, he will be the one facing PL3 next week.
Let's go. Let's go. You want me? Is this what you want?
I want you. You want that title, I want right? that title.
Okay.
I want
the title.
And the law just picking up and putting down Austen G with a big slam.
What was that?
Austen Miguel just handling, just manhandling Austen G, and Austen G is just calling out for his brother. Big elbow shots to the side of the head.
Pick your hand up, pretty boy.
Just strangling that big boot across the face and neck of Austen G, and Austen G goes down to the ground. Wait a minute, Cody Rex has just appeared. Looks like he wants a front row seat to tonight's main event. Cause in 2 weeks, Cody Rex does get a chance at this title. He wants to know if he's gonna be going up against Officer Miguel or Austen G.
Come on, champ!
Going to the top rope here. Going flying, and Officer Miguel just catches Austen G.
What happened now, champ?
Shut!
Oh, he hits him with the authority. Going for the pin. Could he get it? Going for a two count there. Only enough for a two count.
I'm gonna make it a three. Maybe a four. I don't know yet.
Spinning Austen G inside out. And just going right across the back and going to the top of the head again. Austen G is down again. Doesn't look to be good for Austen G. Oh, and a big drop kick to the chest and the ladder.
I can do better.
Yeah, you can. You fat piece of shit.
Looks like Austen G has some ideas with that ladder now. Placing Officer Miguel on top of it. Looks like Austen G is deciding to go to that top rope. By Austen G.
And that's the same way you're gonna fall, Maverick. Piece of shit.
You gotta wonder if Alex G is watching this match.
One,
going for that pin count again. Only getting the two. Austen G rolling out the ring to see what he can grab.
You got in your hands.
Oh my god, ladies and gentlemen, it's Tax! It is Thumbtacks!
You gotta be kidding me! You! You're really about to do this!
Shut the hell up. No one wants to hear your stupid voice.
Jesus Christ! You're a madman, Austen!
I wonder what Austen G is thinking about doing here. With a big right shot! K9 suplex by Officer Miguel.
Are you going, Japs?
Yeah. Move all the weapons, Russo. Move all the weapons. I don't know.
Looks like Austen G is starting to run, but Officer Miguel grabs him before he can go anywhere further. Looks like Austen Miguel is grabbing some more light tubes, ladies and gentlemen.
Ready to have fun, Austen! Remember getting hit by those?
No. Keep it.
This does not seem to be good news for Austen G. Austen G preventing the suplex doesn't want to go on top of those light tubes. Eat the feet by Austen G, standing Officer Miguel into the light tubes. Austen G is grabbing another light tube there, just stomping it on the chest of Officer Miguel. It seems like Austen G has no remorse for his opponent here.
Get you up.
Austen G sending back Officer Miguel into the ring, ladies and gentlemen. Again, ladies and gentlemen, Austen G has no backup because last week, Alex G was fired.
Grenade!
Trying to set up for the grenade on top of a chair. Instead, a Law and Order DDT nearly breaking the neck of Austen G on that chair.
Alex.
Alex. If you covered him by now, you would have won.
I'm finished yet.
Alex, I see you. He's not here. He's not here! He is fired! Gone! Contract expired!
Calling out his brother's name. Oh, and a big chair shot to the skull of Austen G. We have to have a new champion after this, ladies and gentlemen. That was just a brutal chair shot.
I think it's about time I take him downtown!
I've been there.
Officer Miguel ready to take Austen G downtown.
I want to nick him. Nice and stiff for Austen.
Oh, and a big low blow shot burned by Austen G. Austen G setting up for the grenade.
It's fucking over!
Grenade on the attacks! Grenade on the attacks!
One.
Is that it?
Two,
is that it, ladies and gentlemen?
One, two, three, that's it!
And that's the end of the match, ladies and gentlemen. Austen G is still your Shockwave champion. But it doesn't look like Austen G is done here. Looks like he wants to add some more pain to show Cody Rex what he's in store for. And once again, another grenade onto the text. Austen G demanding for his title already. Right, left, he's toothless. Not cute, but the big homie's ruthless. With my two fists, I can move this. And by the fact that I can move it with my true spit, I'm locked in. Despite not having his brother, Austen G did pretty good tonight. And next week he'll be battling PL3. Speaking of PL3, here he comes right now.
What's up, everyone? It's Queen Liz once again, and I'm here with PL3.
Hello, Queen Liz, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. Now, PL3, next week we all know that you have a match with Austen G.
That's right, ma'am. I do have a match with Austen G. And I just found out that Joey Russo said I get to choose that match.
Oh, okay.
It could be hardcore. It could be another last man standing, since I didn't get to finish the other one because of the bloodline. But you know what? I want to do something where Austen G's at a disadvantage, and I'm at an advantage. I want to have a submission match, which is a first on ESW Shockwave. So, Austen G, be prepared, because I am going to strangle you to death.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you heard it right here. A submission match next week for the title. We'll see you then.